Again, as I said from the beginning, Bangkota or the Philippines Pavilion will not compete with any of our neighboring countries in the area of sustainability. The people gets to feel that aura of authenticity from our pavilion. We will present ourselves truthfully. Well, for me, the way to see this and really experience it, there are five stages or five spots. First, I would love the people to be out from the outside itself, from the very there, the very beginning. I would like people to see it from here, from this very spot, to stand outside and see the architecture, how it announces itself. This is where I would like the people to start knowing the project or knowing the Philippines Pavilion. Because it is an introduction, it is an announcement, and where we want to bring the country. So if you notice the architecture with its open, the open middle part of it creates a welcoming gesture, and the permeability of it, no? The openness, how see-through, how transparent the architecture is. It was designed to mimic the very personality of the Filipinos. So this is one important spot. The second spot would be the feeling as you go in to understand now the soul of the person. So if when you go inside, there is nature is peace. No? The first part of the interiors, the Philippines and its history and our own identity is again anchored to nature, and we are not limited by the inspirations of our colonizers. And then the third, if you pause here, this part, no? The third is the next portion, which is man is nature. The idea here is by seeing this, no, and understanding our oneness with nature, we were able to somehow navigate, we were able to travel, we were able to read the ocean, no? We were able to travel the seas and able to make boats and own nature itself, no? We were one with nature. That's why we were empowered. No? And then the fourth is the variety of the world. Confidence, conviction, dignity, honor, integrity, humility, and respect. These are all important things, but you have to know where it's coming from. No? It has to free the minds of the Filipinos. That again, the variety of the world tells us that we are all equally important as the rest of the countries all over the world. We learn how to be confident to ourselves that we also have a value. At the same time, we also respect the value of the rest of the countries and the rest of the race all over the world. When you go through the Bangkota, when you go through the whole passage of Bangkota, what we just wanted to be the takeaway for any visitor is to be able to have that curious mind of asking, where did I come from? Where did I really come from? My history is all about nature. No? Either you're French, you're Italian, you're American. As humanity, our source, our real history is nature. So this whole idea of the experience of Bangkota is gonna set a big question mark to any human being that will pass through it and be able to take it out and bring it out there and think about it. And the last part, I would say together, the major space of the gift to the world, we will be showing here our story, our evolution, no, as people, and again, it's gonna be shown in that giant screen. And again, the story is just to be able to express that reset of the minds of the Filipinos. The sixth space, it's the imaginarium, because after going through this black and void space, no, where you have all these installations of our message, you step out and you now go through the space and go up to the architecture's deck and be able to ascend and have a moment of tranquility, no? A moment for you to ponder, to think about what you saw. For me, that's those are the major spots. Those are the major experiences that the people, yeah, should see. Not just Filipinos, but also our guests, our visitors. Because as I said, Bangkota is for the Filipinos, for the resets of their minds. But it is really for humanity.